Hello and a very warm welcome to all of you on our show now streaming. I am Rumana. हमेशा की तरह मैं आपके लिए ले आई हूँ चुनिंदा फिल्म्स और शोज जो आप घर बैठे देख सकते हैं. Stay tuned for our brand new binge list. State of Siege is a combat drama streaming on Z5. Akshay Khanna stars in this fictional story, which is inspired by the real-life terrorist attack on the Akshardham temple in Gandhinagar. I hear this one is worth a watch. If you like Malayalam cinema, then you know that Fahad Fazil is among the best. Fazil plays the protagonist in Malik, streaming on Amazon Prime from July 15. After the phenomenal success of Bhag Milka Bhag, Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra and Farhan Akhtar are back with another sports drama, Tufan. July 16, yani 16 se, आप देख सकते हैं फरहान अख्तर की शानदार अदाकारी ऑन Amazon Prime. गहरे अंधेरे
सुनी रहे ए, अजीज अली पर 5 साल का बैन लगाया गया है.
तो ऐसा क्या मांग लिया तुमसे कि तुमने ये सब कदम उठाया?
जिस गिल ने तेरे को इज्जत दिया उसका तूने मिसयूज किया.
बॉक्सिंग तुम्हारी लाइफ है अजीज.
अरे सब टूट गए.
प्यार इश्क मोहब्बत कहीं भी कभी भी हो सकता है. फील्स लाइक इश्क एक्सप्लोर्स 6 डिफरेंट लव स्टोरीज. कैसा होता है प्यार का अलग अलग एहसास पता लगाए नेटफ्लिक्स पे फ्रॉम जुलाई 23rd.
लव होता है लेकिन वो कुछ टाइम ही रहता है. उसके बाद आते हैं कॉम्प्रोमाइजेस, अनफुलफिल्ड ड्रीम्स, रिजेंटमेंट एंड फाइनली द फीलिंग ऑफ बीइंग स्टक.
दिस इज नॉट माय बैटल. यू वर सपोज्ड टू बी माय रिबाउंड फकिंग पक.
How can you do that, Maninder?
इतना क्यों डरता है अपने फैमिली से?
सब लोग तेरे जैसे नहीं होते.
चूतिया पा ना यूनिवर्सल होता है, चाहे बॉयफ्रेंड हो या गर्लफ्रेंड.
मैंने तुमसे कोई बात छुपाई नहीं.
क्या फाइन, आई डिड इट फॉर द मनी इन द बिगिनिंग बट देन आई डिड इट फॉर यू.
मैं भी स्मार्ट बन सकता हूँ जी. आई डिडंट नो.
एक दिन के लिए बहुत कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स दे चुकी हूँ तुम्हें.
सो शुड वी किस नाउ?
प्रियदर्शन इज बैक विद अनदर क्रेजी कॉमेडी हंगामा 2. इस फिल्म में है परेश रावल, शिल्पा शेट्टी और मिजान जाफरी. विल दिस वन बी अनदर लाफ्टर रायट? फाइंड आउट बिकॉज द फिल्म हैज इट्स डिजिटल रिलीज ऑन डिज्नी हॉटस्टार फ्रॉम जुलाई 23rd.
तुम्हारे पास क्या सबूत है कि तुम इसके पति हो?
हाँ हाँ सबूत है, शादी का सर्टिफिकेट.
ये क्या है?
आप देखिए पूरा जला नहीं, अल्लाह कसम.
अल्लाह कसम?
तो धर्म बदलने पर कोई पुराने भगवान थोड़ी बुलाए जाते हैं. अब ऐसे सबने कहा कि सबका मालिक है, तू सबके नाम पे फेंक.
साले के मुंह के अंदर बैठ के बंदूक चलाऊंगा तो ही मरेगा.
हमने प्यार किया तो.
In our special section today, we have with us actor Ankur Bhatia, who is joining us from US. Ankur has worked with Aishwarya in Sarbjit and is now a part of various OTT projects like Aarya. A very warm welcome to you, Ankur, on Yahoo India. My first question to you is, Ankur, you have worked with established stars like Aishwarya and Sushmita. Was it ever intimidating for you when you approach these roles, like when your first day of shoot?
Actually,
To be honest, I'm not from the industry. I've not been in Bombay. I landed in Bombay when I was almost about 29, had worked as a banker for 6 years. So from a very different background, what I mean to say. And so I was very naive and unaware of how it would be, of the fact to be standing and sharing the screen with them. So as an actor, I never thought that, you know, like, for example, Sarbjit, when I was starting, I did not know that Aishwarya Rai is playing the role of Dalbir for the longest time. I tested a couple of times with the casting director, then met Umang Kumar, then finally got that. I knew that it was going to be a big actor, like a very well-known actor, but I didn't know it was Aishwarya Rai. I met Aishwarya Rai on the first day of my shoot, my scene, when I was supposed to throw her out of the house. So for me, I never got the chance to actually interact with them and get in the awe of, oh, Aishwarya Rai is walking on the set and this and that, you know, all the hoopla around like the stardom and the aura. I was just thrown into it. So, and from there, it always began like, it has always been like that with Sarbjit, that inhibition ended up. And then I did Haseena Parker for that. I had workshops with Shraddha Kapoor, and also that, that she had done so many movies, so many big songs. And, you know, she was a very well, known actress, established actress, to be honest. And then Sushmita Sen also, I was thrown into the workshop right away from the first day. So it, I never got into that, oh, I'm working with Sushmita Sen or Aishwarya Rai, which helped, you know, in my performance.
If we look at your filmography, you know, you have done a lot of different kind of roles. What are the roles that you really enjoy doing? Do you like playing the hero, or do negative characters excite you more?
You know, I love being in front of the camera. I have started with a silent film in New York, which I thought had probably would be like a film with dialogues and sound and everything, and it had nothing. And still I enjoyed it. And from there, you know, I have been, I did almost about 17, 18 independent short films in New York. And then I landed up in Bombay with the dreams of becoming a big actor and star. And I got a very small part in Zanjeer, where I'm playing Prakash Raj's henchman. Now in the whole gamut of stars in the film, from Priyanka Chopra to Sanjay Dutt, I mean, where will a henchman be seen? Like, you know, it's always coming and going. You have one line. I loved it because there was so much to learn. I was watching them play. I was watching Prakash Raj. I was watching Ram Charan, Priyanka Chopra doing what they do. And it was just a great learning experience. So I enjoyed. So what I mean to say is, everywhere I go and every project I take, there is so much to learn. And as an actor, you're constantly learning. I have derived that the learning never stops. I mean, till date, there are some times that we have to give screen tests and auditions, and you're still learning about the process because it's constantly changing. As an audience, people are constantly changing. Their demands are changing. What they're expecting from actors is changing. And so we have to constantly change. So I get excited with every time I'm in front of the camera. I get, whether it's a henchman, whether it's a main villain, whether it's a, as an actor, my job is to make the audience believe what I'm saying. And for that particular moment, they should not feel like, oh, it's Ankur Bhatia. They should feel that that's Sangram or that's Baldev from Sarbjit, you know. So that's my intent and that's my goal.
You have had quite an incredible journey, Ankur, and not many people know about that. So tell us a little bit about your journey from Bhopal to US and then to, you know, all these mainstream films and web series.
It's a story of a confused child, I must say. So I was born and raised in Bhopal, middle-class family, same kind of house drama, and we want our son to become a computer engineer. And so that race for that was on since I was in school. And I always had an interest in like drama or taking part in fashion show in the school and all. And I never got an opportunity because I was lanky, and suddenly I grew tall when I was very young. And so it was like, you know, you have that dream that I want to be that, but you don't fit the bill at all from any angle. And that was my case. So eventually I landed up in an engineering school in Indore. I did my engineering. And then everybody was going to US to pursue their masters. And I followed the herd, and I was so confused with during my undergrad, I didn't know what to do. I did not want to be a computer engineer. I became a computer engineer. Then everybody was coming to the US. So my dad had this dream that my son should go to America. And so I came here. Then I did not enjoy computer science. So I ended up doing mathematics because one of my ex-girlfriend was doing mathematics. So I thought that was a good, way to be around her. And so I got into mathematics. And from there, I became an actuary. From an actuarial job, I became a banker. Then I wanted to come to New York. So I moved to New York. Then New York was the place where I was I was a late bloomer. So I was around at that time, 26, 27. And I was just getting a foothold of where my life is going. And just bumped into someone who was casting for something. They said, are you an Indian actor? And I was like, no, I was taking. But, you know, all the previous inclinations and dreams about being on stage or being in fashion or being a celebrity came. And I was like, yeah, sure. And I started from there. And a few failures, and I realized that this is what I want to do. And I took it really on my heart to pursue it. And then, I went to LA for 6 months. I was trying to get a film there, and I did not. Because I didn't fit the Indian bill, according to them. I couldn't play a cab driver. I was too good looking for that. So I ended up landing to Bombay. And Bombay, I'd met Apoorva Lakhia here in New York. So I went to meet him. And, as they say, right time, right place. I was there at the right time because one of the actors had just opted out of the film. And he said, would you want to do this part? It'll be a good learning experience. I started doing that. It was a 10-day part. It took about 2 years to complete that 10-day part because Sanjay Dutt was having his legal issues, and the film was going just on and off the floor, and somehow it took 2 years. But by that time, I had managed to gain a foothold in the industry of knowing what's done, where casting directors, this and that. And so the process began, and 8 years have passed by. I'm still here.
So like you said, Ankur, you have been a late bloomer, and it's been 8 years that you have been around doing parts. In this journey, at any moment, did you doubt your decision to take up acting? Did it ever feel like you were better off doing mathematics?
I think you always doubt yourself when financially you're not doing well. And then especially in acting, finances start becoming a little better very late when you start getting jobs. And because a lot of times I've been asked this question that what would you like to take up as your next role, or what's your dream role or something like that, right? Coming from outside, you don't get to choose the roles. You're constantly struggling and hustling, and so by the time you get the part, you are nowhere close to talking about money and negotiations. It's like, whatever's going to be offered to you, you're going to take it. And at that point of time, you really go back to the process of thinking whether it was a right decision to get into this. Because financially, it's not lucrative. I mean, you make tons of money in a job. In any technical field or any field that you have chosen out of college, and if you're doing a 9-to-5 or any other stream,
I mean, it's a steady flow. This is so
erratic and it's unpredictable, and money flow is just not there. It'll come, and then again, it can be a lull for 8 months. So at that point, you do start doubting yourself because everyone around you starts giving you that feeders that, oh, whether you made the right decision or not, you have to be very headstrong in order to go for it, because you have to be confident that it will come as your craft will grow, as your visibility will grow to the audience. And you have to be confident about it. I was always confident that, it will work out eventually. I knew where I was weak, what my weak points were, what were the areas that I needed to work on. And I'm still working on that.
Ankur, you mentioned right now that, you know, as an actor, you can't be a chooser a lot of times, right? Whatever is offered to you, you have to take it up. So there is a lot of conversation around how there is too much sex on the OTT platforms. As an actor, when you are offered a role, say, which is kind of adult or risque in nature, are you comfortable doing that or do you have inhibitions?
I have inhibitions. I tend to, so see, there are, I see these scenes in a show on OTT as, are they really required, or whether that's the main selling point of that show. And even if it's a main selling point of the show, who's the maker of the show? Because that can tell you a lot about how it's going to be. I mean, it's not, or who's the producer of, there are certain segments of OTT, which are known to produce or create content, which is just sex driven. And that's their market. There's nothing wrong about it, but that's the market. That's the audience they are targeting. And I then decide whether it's aligning with my career goal or not. Whether, if you see the kind of work I have done, I have intentionally stayed away for like year or year and a half. And there are gaps in my career. It's because I did not want to do certain kind of roles. I did not want to be a same kind of, like after Haseena and Sarbjit, the number of roles that were coming to me were all husbands. And I was like, no, I don't want to do that. It doesn't excite me anymore. This is, I have taken a huge risk in my career not to follow the herd or not to just flow with the thing. I want to make my own decisions and choices and intelligent ones. And that's what I do. And so, I mean, if someday I feel like I really like the maker of the show and I really like the producer and I know that it's going to take my career to another level, then yeah, I would probably see the option of doing that thing. But unless and until it satisfies those criteria, I try to stay away because it's not a comfort zone for me.
If you had to pick, you know, like the, you have done your fair share of roles in films and also in the OTT space. If you had to pick in a, when you look at scripts, and do you think the OTT platform right now is much more exciting than the film space, where the roles seem to be more stereotypical, you know, like people are, it's like a more hero-centric kind of roles?
I mean, it's constantly, it's changing. The kind of films that are coming out now, you can't actually predict they're going to be a theatrical release, especially in the time that we are in right now. It can be on Netflix, it can be on any other OTT platform. So you never know where the film is going to land up, given the scenario with COVID and lockdowns. But having said that, you know, OTT has its own charm. OTT has given me what no film had given me. And I love doing films because, you know, film has everything big about cinema is in films, like, you know, the bigger
larger
set,
than life.
Bigger internet, larger than life. And so there's no doubt that film is a total different experience. But having said that, if you see business-wise, OTT has helped so many actors recently. We wouldn't be even seen in a film. I mean, if you take a two or three big stars in a film, the film revolves around those stars. So all the supporting cast, they're there. They're a good part. Like, for example, Sarbjit. My part was really great, but people didn't recognize me because during Haseena Parker's press interview, a lot of press people didn't know that I was a part of Sarbjit. It's that when I told them that I was that part, they realized, oh, okay. Because the center of attraction is the main actors. Now in OTT, the show has episodes. So every supporting character or primary character has an arc, get a bigger space, you know, and certain kind of audience will appreciate certain actor, certain kind of, there's a lot more that happens on OTT. And so right now, I think it's a dream come true for actors. They've been shining from left, right, and center.
I hope you continue to shine, Ankur. I want to thank you for your time and all the best for Aarya and Crackdown, your and other upcoming projects.
Thank you very much.
I hope you liked our show today, and if you did, please don't forget to like, share and comment. We are looking forward to hearing your views. Hasta la vista, folks.